Milk Tea Alliance. Twitter creates emoji for pro-democracy activists. This comes from the BBC. Twitter has launched a new emoji for the Milk Tea Alliance, a movement uniting Asian pro-democracy activists. The alliance has brought together anti-Beijing protesters in Hong Kong and Taiwan with pro-democracy campaigners in Thailand and Myanmar. And what the BBC doesn't tell you is there are actually two common denominators here. One, all of these activist groups hate China. And two, they're all funded by the US government via the National Endowment for Democracy. And it's as simple as just going to the NED's own website and looking up each of these countries. Here is Thailand. Here is Myanmar, which they're still calling Burma, and Hong Kong. Twitter said, during times of civil unrest or violent crackdowns, it's more important than ever for the public to have access to the open internet for real-time updates, credible information, and essential services. And when you see this, when they say credible information, they're telling you that they are censoring information off of their networks. Twitter is deleting anyone who opposes the US-dominated narrative. And I've shown many examples of this. This is about in Thailand. They found over 900 accounts that they deleted off of their network because they can reliably link them to the Royal Thai Army. When you word it that way, reliably linked means you have no evidence. You can't show anyone any evidence, because if you did, you would just show the evidence that they were linked to the Royal Thai Army, and that would be that. They word it this way because they have no evidence. These were people standing up for the country against the US-backed agitators and violent mobs, and Twitter deleted them. Here is another example. Twitter suspends Thai royalist account linked to influence campaign. And again, it's the same hand waving. And in reality, all they were doing was deleting opponents to US-backed regime change so that only one narrative prevailed on Twitter, this US-based social media network. And I've pointed out many times how US-based social media networks work directly with the US State Department. Here is an example of Twitter working with the US State Department. US State Department speaks to Twitter over Iran. The US State Department contacted Twitter, urged them to delay a planned upgrade that would have cut daytime service to Iranians who are disputing their election. And in reality, the US was running a violent color revolution in Iran. They were using Twitter to coordinate it, and they did not want that service disrupted in the middle of their operation. And I want to point out this New York Times article. This is from 2011. It's a great article because it admits to everything. US groups helped nurture Arab uprisings, and they admit that the US government was funding all of those opposition groups. There was nothing spontaneous or self-organized about it at all. These people were trained for years in advance. And it even admits in the article, some Egyptian youth leaders attended a 2008 technology meeting. Among those sponsoring the meeting were Facebook, Google, MTV, Columbia Law School, and the US State Department. So they've been working hand in hand for over a decade. They're still doing it. And Twitter making this emoji for the Milk Tea Alliance. The Milk Tea Alliance is a US State Department project. Southeast Asia is full of governments who have constructive relationships with China and will never cut those relationships because the US told them to. So the US has organized these opposition groups to overthrow these governments and to replace them with client regimes that will cut ties with China. The announcement is a big moment for Netiwit. This is a Thai activist. And we all remember Netiwit. He was at the Oslo Freedom Forum. Here he is doing his talk at the Oslo Freedom Forum, and the BBC themselves. This is what the BBC themselves admit about the Oslo Freedom Forum.
Evoke the spirit of the barricades. But the teaching here is to be successful, to topple a government for good, you have to be organized and to plan meticulously. And activists here have been involved in helping to organize the current protests in Hong Kong. Their plan to put thousands of people on the streets of the territory was in fact hatched nearly 2 years ago.
So there you have it. So every aspect of this story the BBC is trying to tell us about these activists and Twitter supporting them, they try to make it as if this was all just happening on its own and they all united together on their own. No, they didn't. They're all funded and backed and directed by the exact same people in Washington, D.C. Again, this is the danger of allowing a US-based social media platform to dominate your nation's information space. Southeast Asia is over-dependent on Facebook and Twitter. They need to develop their own platforms, and they need to push these US-based social media networks out of their information space. If you thought this video was useful, please like and share it. Think about subscribing to my channel. It helps the channel grow, and it's free to do. Check the video description for all the links that I used making this video, as well as for ways you can help support my work. And as always, thank you very much for watching.